In this video, we walk you through setting up your Volt interface with Pro Tools. First, make sure that Volt is connected to your computer and powered on. If using Windows, make sure to download and install the ASIO driver via the UA Connect app. No additional driver download is required for macOS. Next, open Pro Tools. On the left of the dashboard window, click on Create. Confirm your settings by clicking on Create at the bottom, and the new session will open. In the top menu, click on Setup and choose Playback Engine. Set the playback engine to the Universal Audio Volt driver using the drop-down menu. After the playback engine is changed, Pro Tools will ask to save, close, and reopen the session. Confirm by clicking on Yes and the session will close. Set the buffer size from the drop-down menu. Increasing the buffer size can alleviate playback issues like clicks, pops, and distortion caused by high CPU loads, but will also increase latency when playing virtual instruments or monitoring inputs through the software. A common workflow is to use a lower buffer size while recording and to use a higher buffer size when mixing. Confirm the settings by clicking on OK and the session will reopen. In the top menu, click on Setup and choose I/O. In the I/O setup, all Volt inputs and outputs need to be available as a path so that they can be selected as the input or output for a track. If the shown paths on the Input tab do not reflect Volt's available inputs, then select all paths and delete these. Then click on Default and Pro Tools will automatically fill in the paths based on the inputs provided by Volt's driver. Repeat the same process for the Output tab if needed. Click OK to close the window. In the top menu, click on Track and choose New. Click on Create to make a new audio track. Go to the Mix window and choose the input that you want to record from the drop-down menu. To be able to select the input in the Edit window, make sure that the I/O panel is displayed by opening the menu on the left and checking I/O. If you are using Volt's direct monitoring feature, make sure to deactivate software input monitoring by checking Low Latency Monitoring in the Options menu. Now you can record and enable the track and start recording.